In the year we call 1783, two brothers named Montgolfier flew the first passengers suspended in a hot air balloon, a sheep, a rooster, and a duck. The flight, which lasted 8 minutes, took place in front of Louis XVI, Marie Antoinette, and the French court, as well as a crowd of about 130,000 spectators. The balloon flew nearly 2 miles before returning its occupants safely to Earth. Today, in the summer of 2008, we fly a machine powered by the combustion of petroleum. Again, we are presented with a new perspective of a landscape we cannot comprehend from the ground. During the mid-20th century, in the forest that used to stand here, a chemist named Carl Clark spent much of his life trying to figure out how to separate bitumen from sand. It took him nearly 45 years, but he eventually perfected a hot water process using his wife's washing machine. In 1965, Clark got to see the first commercial application of his invention, creating the mine to feed his process. Required the slashing and burning of thousands of trees. Clark was disturbed by the realization that he had spent most of his life making this kind of destruction possible. Before he died of cancer in December 1966, he told his daughter Mary that he could never revisit this place. What we have seen here below shows only 3% of the potential tar sands development carried out since the days of Carl Clark. The expected life of the sun is another 15 billion years. We have made ingenious use of petroleum for 80. What will we do next?